Hey, and welcome to the show. My name's Kristy Romijn.
And I'm Patrick Imbery. Today we have a terrific show lined up for you.
Coming up, we've got the highlights of the 4th Annual Western Canadian Volleyball Tournament.
As well, we have news reports on the Christmas Shoebox campaign and last month's award night.
I didn't get an award, but that's okay, because lots of people did. We've got a report about it coming up. So stay tuned, MCTV Live is coming up next.
Welcome back.
Last week was Halloween. Did you wind up doing anything ghoulish or trick-or-treating related, Pat?
Nope, I was working here at the school.
Yeah, me too. However, our school is definitely in the trick-or-treating spirit. We sent our MCTV guys, Rudy Klinger and Stefan Mazik, to cover our MCTV events.
The events included pumpkin carving contests and the ever-popular Dress Up the Teacher competition.
Mr. B didn't show up because he chickened out. We were going to dress him up like a girl.
Yeah, it'd be funny.
Little frilly pink dresses?
Yes. Well, here's their report.
Reporting for MCTV Live. Outside, it's October the 28th, but inside the school, it's a fun-filled day of Halloween activities. The day began with a teacher dress-up. Here we see Mr. Sky in his cool glasses. Many of the teachers enjoyed the activity, especially the parade. And here we see Mr. Nolan wind up winning the first prize. So Mr. Nolan, how did it feel to win first prize?
Well, I was really proud of my crew. They arranged it, came up with a theme, brought all the materials, had fun putting it together. So I'm really happy for them all.
Do you feel like a fool yet?
Well, not particularly, though. Perhaps when I arrive home tonight, my wife thinks I might have lost a couple marbles.
The afternoon continued with the pumpkin carving contest. Grade 10's Craig Freestead took home third prize with his black pumpkin, and our own MCTV pumpkin took home second prize, while Mike Loney took home the grand prize with this stunning pumpkin. The afternoon continued with the raunchy relay. Here we see Ryan Darren getting wrapped in many rolls of toilet paper. Doesn't he look like he's having fun? Along with our grade 9 representative also getting wrapped in toilet paper. It was a great afternoon. Everyone was on their feet and out of their chairs once they were about to announce the costume winner for grade 10. Who, without a doubt, was Stephen Bell, also known as Sparkles. We then got reactions from people once they started to file out of the gym. So what did you think of the celebration?
I don't know, I thought it was pretty cool.
Oh, it was excellent! Yeah! Woo!
Where'd you get your inspiration for the costume?
My main woman here.
Sparkles.
Sparkles.
That's just great, man.
Yeah. I'm a Grandmaster Pink.
We're back.
Coming up next, we have a brand new segment.
That's right. Jocelyn Foss is down in center court, ready to show us our new view of MCTV's new game.
I believe it's called Skech, and gives students and staff at MCA Chess a chance to win some wonderful prizes.
If you're interested in being a contestant, you can contact Mr. Biostein at the address we're going to show on our screen. I don't know if it's up yet or not, but it'll be on your screen.
So, without further ado, here's Jocelyn.
Hi, I'm Jocelyn Foss, and welcome to Skech. On today's show, well, on our first show, we have, well, I guess I have to explain the rules a little bit. There, we have two groups of two today. There's supposed to be three, but our third group did not show up.
Oh.
And if you can't hear me, go down to CTS2. They have much better sound down there. So each team, the rules are, each team has 1 minute to draw six different things. And then one person draws and then the other person has to try and guess what the other person is drawing. And we would ask that the people down in center court do not yell out any answers. Okay, well, for our first group we have
Jenny Crawford
and Colette Maggio. And we also have in group two
Amanda Braley and Amanda Morrow.
Okay, this is our first show. And, okay, everybody's being really loud down here. Okay, we have six different categories. Our first category is, we have place, animal, action, difficult, Edmonton area, and our mystery category, which we'll go through later on. Right for now, we'll have a quick word from our sponsors.
Axe Music. Music, light, sound, and video. Come into our guitar department with a wide variety of bass, electric and acoustic guitars, amps, and accessories. Our drums department has an assortment of drums, cymbals, and sticks. For DJs, we have all sorts of mixers and accessories. Also check out our rentals and other departments. Axe Music, 11931 72nd Street, Edmonton, 471-2001.
On the Halloween weekend, MCHS hosted the Western Canadian Challenge Volleyball Tournament.
96 teams from as far away as Texas, Nevada, and California competed in the largest high school tournament in Canada.
MCTV was covering all the action, which included a three-hour live broadcast on the women's final.
I, along with Courtney Wellwood, put a little piece together documenting everything that went on to put this massive tournament together.
And for those of you who missed our live broadcast, it was the men's final too. Sorry, I didn't mention it. Jason Brennice has put together a piece of all the highlights of the men's and women's finals.
Hi, my name is Patrick Imbery with MCTV. Many MCHS shirts and hamburgers were sold because we hosted the Western Canadian Challenge, and many of the volleyball players from other provinces and states bought from us. Here's one of our devoted fans.
Tigers player, and what is your name?
Michelle.
Michelle, how do you think your team is going to do in this tournament?
Well, so far we've made it to the top four, so we're really, really hoping to win this next game. This is like our rival team. We've traveled twice to Winnipeg. We made it in the final both times against them, and they beat us both times, so this is like our revenge round. This is where we really want to beat them.
Yeah, and I wish you luck.
On the night of the Western Canadian Challenge, it was Halloween. And some of the people that attended decided it would be a good idea to dress up for the tournament.
My name is Leo Brusiker, and I'm the president of the St. Albert Breakfast Lions Club. We were one of the four clubs that sponsored the Lions International Canadian Challenge. Well, we were approached. Dan Bastian, the tournament director, and he asked if we would become a title sponsor. And that's sort of like golf companies will do with golf tournaments. They put their name on the tournament, and we decided that we wanted to do that because we wanted to help the young athletes of Western Canada have an opportunity to take part in a great big tournament.
And here is the gold-winning team.
From the Prince Albert, Saskatchewan group, and they just won gold. How does it feel?
It feels pretty good. It was a really long day. Finished off real late, but it feels really good.
My goals and models. The first model or goal I have is I'm a volleyball coach, but I think what I do best is I help people build themselves up, or I help build men.
Hi, I'm Patrick Imbery, and big congratulations to the teams that won. And to the teams that didn't, it's not whether you win or lose, it's how you play the game. And here's some highlights of the Western Canadian Challenge.
Please. Now, here's a highlight package from the tournament. On the women's side, River East of Winnipeg, Manitoba, and Sierra High of Toll House, California, battled it out. The first game was taken by River East, score 15-8. In the second game, the winners were River East again by a score of 15-8. The women's MVP was Laura Gruber of River East. The women's All-Stars were Carolyn Boyku, Candice Dufresne, Chelsea Poley, Marla Lee, April Psycho, and Sarah Walter. For the men, the winning team is Carlton Comprehensive, Prince Albert, Saskatchewan. They faced Louis St. Laurent of Edmonton, Alberta. For the first game, Carlton lost by 3, but in the second they won by 8, and in the third by 7. The men's MVP is number 10, Dennis Dazio of PA Carlton. The men's All-Stars were Matt Bandit, Chris Gilliard, Trent Mason, Rahul Mathur, Marcel Monroe, and Tony Selkirk.
Those volleyball highlights were really cool.
They sure were.
But I think the best part of the entire tournament was the free food that we got for working here.
Thank you, Miss Karen, and the rest of the cafeteria staff for the great food.
Coming up, we'll rejoin Jocelyn Foss down at Center Court for more Skech, which I believe Chrissy Haslam and I will be hosting next show. But first, we've got a news report on the award ceremonies last month. So check it out.
Okay, thanks and welcome back to Skech. Our first group up is Colette and Jenny. And I take it, Colette, you're drawing?
I am.
Okay, so Jenny, that means you're guessing, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, Colette, here are your words. Now, Jenny, wait till I say go, okay? Are you clear on all of them? Oh, and today's mystery category is children's movies. Okay. Are you ready? Are you Mark? Get set. Go.
Stairs. Stairs. Down the stairs. Downstairs. Downstairs. All right. Next.
Remember, you do not have to do them in
puddle,
order.
Pond. Cookie.
TV.
Bird. Birdseed. Flower. I have no idea. Parachute. Lips. Next one.
Stairs.
Two cars.
Olympic rings.
Okay. And we have 15 seconds left.
Oh, shoot.
Four bugs and a reindeer.
I don't. Cigarette.
Smoke.
Smoke.
What? Okay, time's up.
Wow.
And I'm really unclear on what's going on right now. What?
Who's the other one in the middle?
Okay.
Who's the one in the middle?
Okay. Okay, they got 9, and we feel really bad. Okay, so we'll go on to our next group and see how good they can do.
Huh? Who's the middle one?
Eat.
Eat?
There's a plate.
Okay, and we have Amanda drawing and Amanda guessing.
And
okay. I guess that last part, this doesn't really count. That's for me. Are you clear on all of them? Okay.
I'm like, where's the downstairs?
On your mark, get set, go. Yep.
Oh, south.
Yes, we did.
Okay.
Yeah, that was a lot.
I'm
We'll give that one to them. We'll give them B.
Paul, oh, what's up with that?
Santa Claus on track.
Okay, and that's time. That was 1 minute. Are we still on? Okay, so I guess our winners are obvious since they actually got one. They got none. Okay, but we'll be back in a moment. After.
I'm here with
Ryan Courtney,
and we're reporting from Morinville Community High School for the MCHS Awards Night.
A huge crowd of students, friends, and family showed up to view the ceremonies.
There were approximately 265 awards given out to our MCHS students, along with a few familiar faces who were around last year.
Various awards were given, including honors, scholarships, and several different CTS awards, and students were more than happy to show them off.
I won the most valuable player for the volleyball team on the JV last year, and I'm really proud of myself, seeing that there were about five of us who were in grade 12. I think I did exceptionally well.
I got the perfect attendance award, an honors award, and a math award, and I feel great.
I received top honors in grade 12 and I am very, very proud.
I received a perfect attendance award and a merit award for grade 12. And I'm very happy.
And of course we want to thank all of our sponsors. There are so many of them we can't list them all, but we want to know that all of the students at MCHS are grateful. Thanks to them, awards night was a true success for everyone.
Thanks, Jocelyn. This Wednesday is Remembrance Day, a day to set aside all our differences and to remember those Canadians who fought bravely and gave their lives so we could be free today.
MCHS will commemorate Remembrance Day with the ceremony in the gym tomorrow during static block.
Whether it be tomorrow or on Wednesday, please take a moment to remember all those people who courageously and heroically fought in battle to sacrifice for their country.
This next piece, put together by several MCTV students, is a tribute to those individuals.
We were there to do a job, and we did it. Well, war is a terrible thing, I think. If I had a great-grandson or close relative going back to war, as I did, I would worry.
Well, I remember it, of course, because of the people that I knew. People who died.
I think it's important for young people to remember that we did go to war at one time. I would hope that they remember, and I would hope that they do all they can as they become leaders to avoid war.
These mist-covered mountains are home now for me. But my home is the lowlands, and always will be. Someday you'll return to your valleys and your farms, and you'll know. Through these fields of destruction, baptisms of fire, I've witnessed your suffering. waste time. And though it didn't help me so bad, in the fear and alarm, you did not desert me, my brothers and I.
The Shoebox campaign is when students are asked to put like gifts and useful objects in a box, and then they're mailed to less fortunate children around the world.
Last week, Mr. Gubish came into our school to orientate the grade 9 and 10 students about this wonderful campaign.
Our MCTV reporters, Sean Winkworth and Wendy Pelche, were there to make sure everything went okay and to kick off this campaign put on by Dr. Gubish.
So here's the kickoff of this year's campaign.
Hi, I'm Wendy Pelche reporting from Morinville Community High School. Up next are the highlights from Dr. Glubish's speech and presentation on Operation Christmas Child, which is also commonly referred to as Operation Shoebox.
Operation Christmas Child, or Shoebox, is basically one of our charity events that we do here in the school. We are preparing shoeboxes with various gifts that we're sending over or down to South America to help underprivileged children. So they actually feel like they're celebrating in the Christmas spirit as well. They
Operation Christmas Child started about 6 years ago in Canada, and the project has been going for about 7 years now. I think one of the things Operation Christmas Child does, it helps, it provides an opportunity for Canadians to share their love for with children who are born in areas that are devastated by war, poverty, and natural disasters. It works great. Last year we had 1.6 million shoeboxes, so that's a lot of shoeboxes. It's very successful. 6 years ago when we started in Canada, we had 17,000 shoeboxes. So we've grown from 17,000 in Canada to this year over 400,000 boxes. And we're shipping to 60 countries this year.
Before I forget, here's a reminder. Next Thursday, or no, sorry, this Thursday, here at MCHS is pajama day. So dress up in your best jammies and come to school. But don't sleep during class. Next, we're going back to Center Court to see who won this version of Skech. And then we've got a piece about the drama play. So enjoy.
The hustle and bustle of Christmas is already in the air, and it's none more evident than in the new drama production, Here's Love, an adaptation of the Miracle on 34th Street story. We talked to some of the characters, and here's what they had to say. Even though they enjoy acting, they are working hard to achieve the meaning of the play, which is starting to come through. Here's what director Debbie Lewiski had to say about this particular production.
This one is a true Christmas show. It's the true spirit of Christmas. It's got lots of Christmas music, and it's just a lot of fun loving music, and I have a fun loving cast
member. Okay. Excuse me, could you please put those down? I'd like to get this going, and I would get rid of the cushions off there.
Yeah, I think it's going well.
Well now, young lady, what's your name?
Susan Walker. What's yours?
I'm Santa Claus.
We caught Jennifer McKinnon. She also has a leading role. She had this to say.
I'm Doris Walker. I am so excited. She's awesome.
We've gotten brand new slippers.
Come on out and enjoy the show. I want to say that your MCTV viewers and the town of Morinville have always supported these productions. So come on out. We're having a good time. So come on out on December 8th to 11th and enjoy.
Okay, thank you very much.
Merry Christmas.
This has been Kristy Romijn.
Hello, and we're back here on Skech. We have decided that there is a tie. Yes, a tie. And the way we've decided to break this tie is I'm going to draw something. Is you're just giving them 30 seconds. And the first person to guess gets it, okay? Is everybody ready?
Woo! Yeah. Yay!
Everybody ready? Because I know what I'm doing. Okay, here we go. Ready? Okay, here we go.
Circle. Pete, person, husband, man. Couple.
Twins. Twins, sisters, brothers, parents, family.
Hair.
Blonde.
Head.
Guy. Girl.
Single person, Chinese double twin. Person, male, female.
Okay, nobody seems to get this one. It was supposed to be behind. This person's behind
because you. Suck. Could have drew a big butt.
Draw a big butt. Okay, well, I guess we're just gonna have to give everybody a prize or something. I guess we'll just have to give you both a prize. We have no other choice. But anyways, that's all for this week's show. See you back on the 24th with great, new, and exciting MCTV live stuff.
Critical, but now I find I'm cynical. A lady with a starving baby miles away from me. No problems here, just life and death. And what the hell is wrong with me? Everybody knows. No questions asked, just get receipts and write them off. Expenses, taxes are a bitch these days. Yet the lady baby starval waiting for a contribution in a UNICEF box in a drugstore in this ugly little town. money, I'll never understand. The world is just a marble in the palm of my hand. The palm of my